सो भाई लोग, हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक टू आर न्यू वीडियो ऑन द चैनल। एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट आइकन स्वैप्स 2, बिकॉज आइकन स्वैप्स 2 जो है वो रिलीज हो चुके हैं और हम लोग उसी के बारे में बात करने वाले हैं कि आइकन स्वैप में 2 में जो जो आइकन आए हैं उसमें मेरी क्या रिकमेंडेशन है और कौन से आइकन ऐसे जो बेस्ट है आउट ऑफ दिस आइकन स्वैप्स 2 ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एंड ऑल जो भी है। तो पहले बात करते हैं, फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट बॉबी मोर। बॉबी मोर इज अ ओके ऑप्शन, बॉबी मोर इज अ ओके ऑप्शन। आई विल नॉट रिकमेंड बॉबी मोर एक्चुअली बिकॉज ही लैक्स इन पेस, हिज फिजिकल इज ओके, ही हैज अ ग्रेट डिफेंडिंग एंड ही लैक्स इन हाइट ऑल्सो। सो हिज स्टैट्स आर एज यू कैन सी, इट्स गुड फॉर डिफेंडिंग बट आई डू नॉट रिकमेंड इट बिकॉज यू कैन चूज सम अदर ऑप्शन दैट आर ग्रेट। सो आई विल रेट बॉबी मोर 5 out of 10. I will give him a rating of 5 out of 10 and I will rate every icon in this video which you are going to see in the upcoming minutes. So Bobby Moore will cost you 5 icon swaps. So this was for Bobby Moore. Second one is Rijkaard, Frank Rijkaard. So Rijkaard is also a good choice. He is more of like a cheap CDM from icon swaps. He is a okay option, I can say a little bit better. Like the rating that I will give to Frank Rijkaard is 6 out of 10, 6 out of 10 because he lacks in stamina, he lacks in balance and agility, but his defending is good. So if you don't want to play that much, so Rijkaard will be for you, for your go-to choice for icon swaps 2 objective. Second one is Rijkaard, so I rate him 6 out of 10, Bobby Moore 5 out of 10. Third one, Fernando Herrero. Actually, the card that is required for Fernando Herrero is 6 and he is a great choice. He is a great choice for 6 icon swaps objective and I would highly recommend you ki, if you don't want to play that much and if you have only 6 icon swaps to invest and you don't have any icon swaps, so you can go for it because he is a very much of a CDM center back kind of a player that you can get and he is okay in all of his aspect. He is 6'2 in height and he's a good option and I would rate him 7 out of 10 because this card is good, not the best but it's good to have for 6. Next one, Van der Sar actually in this game the best goalkeeper is David Dia, Ter Stegen and Neuer, and for that is Van der Sar is the best goalkeeper of the game. If you choose any version of him, he will provide quality in your club, but his mid version and his prime version are great, they are the best. So Van der Sar, if you need a goalkeeper, he will be a great choice for you and I will give him a rating of 9 out of 10 because he is the only goalkeeper in icon swaps and he is the best goalkeeper in icons and all in the game also. So next one, Raul is a great option if you need a cam, if you need a striker. So because Raul is great in finishing, he has great dribbling, shooting stats. So if you need a cam, if you need a striker, then Raul is for you. And I am going to give Raul 9 out of 10 because he is a great option to as a cam, as a striker. You can use him in multiple positions like a striker and cam. So Raul is a great choice. I give him 9 out of 10. Next one, Ronald Koeman. Ronald Koeman is a very good choice for 10 swap deals. And Ronald Koeman is, you can use him as a CM, you can use him as a CDM, you can use him as a center back. All of these three positions he can play great because his stats are insane. He is like a multi-pin charger, you can plug any mobile with him. That was a joke actually, but you can use him with any playstyle, any formation and any position which I have told you earlier, CM, CDM and center back. He is a great choice and I would rate him 9 out of 10. I would rate Roman Coleman a 9 out of 10. Next one, Clearance Seedorf. Seedorf, it is his baby card. Seedorf is a good option if you need a attacking CM. If you need an attacking CM for your squad, so Seedorf will be a good choice and I would give him a rating of 8 out of 10. If you are using, if you want a attacking CM, because he's an attacking kind of a CM, so I will give him a rating of 8 out of 10. And he's a great choice for an attacking CM. Next one, Robert Parris. Robert Parris is a okay option. Not that worthy. He is good as a winger, but not that great. He's only good. So I would give Parris a rating of 6 out of 10. I would not give him higher because he is one of the worst icons in FIFA, from far FIFAs. So Parris, I do not recommend. And Parris, I would rate him 6 out of 10. Next one, Nakata. Nakata is not the best. It is a good choice for a cam, but I do not recommend it. I rate him 6 out of 10 because he lacks in some of his attributes like attacking position and finishing. He will not get into the position that good, but it's a good card. It's a good card to if you want to get him, but I do not recommend it. I rate him 6 out of 10. Next one, Socrates. Socrates is a great option for a cam. He is the most heighted cam that you can get. He's like Patrick Vieira. So this is Socrates, and I rate him 8 out of 10. I rate Socrates 8 out of 10. And the only position that I would suggest you to use Socrates is cam. He is only great at cam. You can use him as a striker, but you have to give him a support of 90 best players. Right back. Next one is Zambrota. Zambrota is a great choice for your right back position. If you haven't chosen Zanetti, and if you want a right back for your squad, he is a great choice for a right back. He has 5-star weak foot. His stats are insane for a right back, and he has also 5-star weak foot. So that is a big advantage with Zambrota. He has 5-star weak foot. If a defender has 5-star weak foot, so he will defend with both of his foot. So that will be a bigger advantage if you need a right back. So Zambrota, I would rate him 9 out of 10. And he required you 10, 11, 12. Next one, Luis Figo. Luis Figo, this card is great to use as a winger, as a cam. You can choose him. It's good. It's a great card to have in the club. If you want to choose a wing player, a cam player, he will be a great choice for you. You can play him as a cam. You can play as a winger. You can play him as a striker also. So I would rate him 9 out of 10. Luis Figo, he's a great choice. Next one, Sol Campbell. Sol Campbell is will require you 14 swipe deals icons, swipe deals players, and he is the best center back in swipe deals. He is the best center back, and he is a great center back also at the same time. And I would highly recommend you to do this if you need a great center back for your club. And he has perfect work rate, perfect defending stats, perfect pace, everything is perfect. And I will give him a rating 10 out of 10. I would give Sol Campbell a 10 out of 10 because he's perfect. And the player, the swap deals player that is required for Sol Campbell is 14. So he is 10 out of 10. I give him a rating of 10 out of 10. Next one, Gary Lineker. Gary Lineker is a striker. He is a, I can say, a great choice here. He is a great choice because he is good in every aspect. You can give him an engine to improve his agility and pace, and after that you can play him as a striker, and I would rate him 9 out of 10 because he is a great striker for finishing and all. And if you don't have Mbappe or Cristiano or Messi like players, so you can get Lineker. Next one, Blanc. Blanc is a attacking CM. He is more of an attacking CM. He has good height, good defending, very balanced card, and it's his baby card, Laurent Blanc. You can take him, and it will require you around 14 swap deals card. So Blanc will be a great choice for you, and I would rate him 9 out of 10 because his CM card is great for attacking and all. So next one, mid icon pack, I do not recommend it, so I will give him this a rating of 5 out of 10 because I do not recommend it. Luck, we cannot depend on our luck. We have to do our hard work to grind for icons, swipe deals and all. So next one is Luis Hernandez. Luis Hernandez, it will be costing you around 19 swipe deals icons players, and Luis Hernandez is a good choice. He is not the best. You can choose him, but the only problem that he lacks in is his weak foot. He has 3-star weak foot, and but his card is good. You can choose him. If you want a PC R cam or L cam for your 4-2-3-1 formation or 4-1-2-1-2 wing formation, you can use him, but he will not provide you good quality for a winger. He is more of a striker and a cam if you want really want to use him as a cam, but I do not recommend it. And I will rate him 6 out of 10 because he lacks in his weak foot is very important if you need a striker. Next one, Barnes will cost you around 19 swipes icons, and he has a great card to use as a striker, as a cam, as a winger. All three positions he can play. He can play good, and it is a very great card to have, and it is an endgame card also. So I would give Barnes a 9 out of 10 because he is a very good card to play all of these three positions. Next one, Del Piero. Del Piero is better as a cam than a striker, but you can also use him as a striker, but you have to give him a good support. He has the one thing that is great is his 5-star foot and his shooting. His shooting is insane, and he's a great card to choose, and you have to invest 20 Swabdeens players to get Del Piero, and he's a good choice, and I would rate him 9 out of 10 because Del Piero is a great cam and as a striker. He's a great card. And next one, we are going towards Ronaldinho. Ronaldinho is a great card to play as a cam. Not the best, but it's a good card. If you are a skiller, if you need skills and with passing and also, Ronaldinho is for skillers. But I do not recommend it because he lacks in stamina, and his stats are insane, but he lacks in stamina. Stamina is a very important thing if you want to carry your player till the end of the match. So you have to sub him, and I do not recommend a player if you are subbing him. Ronaldinho, I will give him a rating of 7 out of 10 because his stamina is very let down. You have to sub him. You have to sub him. Next one. Okay, this is a very tough choice to make. We have top icon choice player, that is Michael Essien and Patrick Vieira. Michael Essien, very balanced card to use as a CDM. These two guys are both are great CDMs. And the thing is, if you need a great link player like players, then you can choose Vieira. Vieira is the best CDM of the game, and the advantage over Essien of Vieira is his height. He has 6'4 height and he has 5'10 height. So height is a big issue with Essien. But Patrick Vieira is a great card. If it's his baby, it's his mate or prime. But Michael Essien is also very well balanced. So I would rate Michael Essien 10 out of 10 because Michael Essien is the best choice out of icon swaps. And Patrick Vieira, I will give 9 out of 10. If it was his mid, so I will rate him 10 out of 10. But baby version, comparing to Michael Essien prime version, Michael Essien is a lot better than Patrick Vieira. But the only advantage of Patrick Vieira is his height. His height is 6'4". So that's all. That's all for this video. And I hope that you will like it and like the rating that I have given. And you can tell your thoughts on this video, comments down below. Also, we are going to meet in our new live stream on new video. Till then, bye bye.